You cannot use for or while loops without iterators. Take this Python code for example. For C in unfathomable, the string, you have to print C. The above Python code will print out each character in the string in every iteration of the for loop. But have you thought about how the program even knows how to go letter by letter through the string? Who told the program that this is a string and you have to print out each letter in the string? In this Python example, the Python authors have made sure to implement an iterator for the string data structure, which tells the program how to iterate through the set data structure. Iterators are a very versatile concept in Rust as well, around which many of the common utility methods such as map, filter, foreach, flatmap, collect, and many more revolve. All of the aforementioned methods cannot be used if you don't convert your struct to an iterator first. Here is an iterator trait. To convert your struct into an iterator, Rust makes us implement this iterator trait on our struct. The Rust Analyzer, which is the language server protocol or the VS Code extension of Rust Analyzer that you can install, is then going to force you to implement a method called next for this iterator. This is where you tell your program how to iterate through your data structure. You will then be asked to implement an associated type, as in the type of element that the iterator will yield during the iteration or while running through any data structure. For example, when running through a data structure X, if you want to yield integers, 32-bit integers, then the associated type would be I32. Or you might have a list of books in a catalog struct such as this. Now, when you want to run a for loop, normally you would run a for loop on something that you intuitively know to be iterable, an array, or in Rust, a vector. But what if I simply want to iterate over the catalog without having to worry about any of the implementation details of catalog? Would I still get the correct answer? How would I still get the correct answer? How is the program supposed to know how to go through the catalog struct? This is why we need the iterator trait. It forces us to tell the program how to go through a certain struct through which the program doesn't know how to go through. How is the program supposed to know what it actually means to go through the word unfaithful? Letter by letter, two letters at a time maybe? Using the iterator trait in Rust, we can specify this. Another way to think about iterators is that it allows you to specify which element you want the access to when you use a for loop in a data structure. Now, without wasting any more time, let's get into the code examples. Now, let's create a new user struct that can be printed to the console. Now, in the main function, let's create a vector of these user objects. Now, since we have a vector of user structs, we can use this vector to create an iterator and further use that iterator to find the sum of the money fields of each user struct in that vector. Now we have the sum of all the money fields in this vector. But what if I didn't want to do this? What if, to illustrate how iterators work, how about we create an iterator who only returns the dollar values of this user array? So it takes the user array and it only returns the dollar value of the money field of each user. To do that, first we'll have to create a new iterator. This user dollar iterator will take a generic argument I, where I will be an iterator and each item in this iterator will be a user. The structure will further have an iterator field, which we will call iter, which will actually hold the iterator. After we've created the structure itself, now we'll have to write a method to create a new object from the struct. Now we can go back to our main function and create a new instance of user.iterator. Since the vector is not an iterator, but it can be converted into an iterator because it implements the intuitor trait, now we can finally start implementing the iterator for this struct. In this code block, we are implementing the iterator trait for the user.iterator struct. We are instructing the implementation that the T is an iterator where each item is of the type user, and each item that will be yielded from this iterator will be of type I32. Now we finally come to the next function, which this implementation is forcing us to implement for this struct, the user.iterator. If you notice right here, what we are doing, that each time we get a value over here, we are moving on to the next value. So this will change every time this is called. Every time the main next function is called, we will also iterate over the vector of users that we have given to this iterator. So when we are finally iterating over the values, for example right here, each time this loop iterates over the dollar iterator, this next method will be called on it, and the next method will also be called on the main iterator that we gave it
which is the vector of users. As I told you before, for this for loop to work, the user$iterator right here needs to implement a next method. And each time we find a valid value in our original vector of user values, we return the sum of the value.money divided by 80, since we want the dollar values of these things. So I'm assuming the main values are in rupees. So if we divide it by 80, we'll get the values in dollars. Let's try and run this. And there it is. Each value was returned after being divided by 80. And that's a little example of how everything works.